Okay, very good morning, children. Yesterday we discussed about the polynomials, types of polynomials, constant polynomial, linear polynomial, quadratic, cubic, and biquadratic polynomials. And also discussed about the linear and quadratic by using the graph. For suppose we observe that something graph is, for suppose y is equal to p of x or f of x be a polynomial. For suppose y is equal to f of x be a polynomial, whatever may be. Now the graph is given. For suppose this one is given. This is y is equal to f of x. For suppose 0, 1, 2, 3, something one. Now how many zeros? Already I told that one yesterday. What the zero meaning? The line. What the linear polynomial or quadratic polynomial or cubic polynomial, whatever may be. If the polynomial intersect the x-axis, that intersecting point is called zero of the polynomial. Here, this is line intersect the y-axis, not the x-axis. Means y equal f of x have. Now this is observe that this is the line y is equal to f of x, the polynomial doesn't intersect the x-axis. That's why number of zeros is equal to nothing, zero. For suppose you will take the polynomial, for suppose you will take the polynomial. How many zeros are possible? Immediately we will see the curve means the polynomial intersect at how many points on x-axis. This one at 2 points, means compulsory to have 2 zeros. For suppose the curve is given in this way. How many zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The polynomial intersect the x-axis at how many points? We observe that. Those points is equal to the number of zeros or number of roots of that polynomial. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One more question is very, very important one. Observe that this is very, very easy. Now today I have discussed about the relation between the roots and the coefficients. Simple, observe that. Very, very easy. What I am telling, the relation between the roots and coefficients. Roots and coefficients, not linear. Linear have exactly one root, one zero. Roots are the relation between the zeros and the coefficients. Zero nothing but the root, no problem at all. Okay. Now, for suppose we will take the one equation. What happened? For suppose 2x square minus 8x plus 6. What about this quadratic polynomial? Quadratic polynomial means compulsory bifurcate the factors. Now we write the product of the two linear factors. X variable power degrees to, this is called quadratic polynomial. Now it's bifurcated into the two factors. Okay. Now first how to divide 2, 6 or 12? First and last coefficient 12. What are the factors? 6, 2s are 12. Yes. This is 2 into 6 means positive 12. 6, 2s are 12. Here 8 is there. -6 - 2 - 8, but -6 - 2, that equal to 12. Now how to write? Now 2x square minus 6x minus 2x plus 6. Now taken common, 2x common, x minus 3, minus 2 common, x minus 3. Now orally common, x minus 3 taken common out, this is 2x minus 2. In this one 2 taken common out. Or here leading coefficient taken common, no problem. In this one 2 taken common, 2 into x minus 1 into x minus 3. Now x minus 1 equal 0, x minus 3 equal 0. Whenever x minus 1 equal 0, x minus 3 equal 0, those are the factors. Now x is equal to 1 comma 3 are the roots. What are the roots of this one? 1 comma 3 are the roots of the above quadratic polynomial. What are the factors? 1 is the root means x minus 1 is the factor. 3 is the root means x minus 3 is the factor. Those product Marston should write in this way. And here the leading coefficient, what is the leading coefficient? 100% you write imprint of that one. Now this is the finding out the, this is the method to finding out the factors of this quadratic expression. Now here x is equal, x minus 1 equal to 0, x minus 3 equal to 0. Now x is equal to 1 and x is equal to 3. Understand? Now 1 comma 3 are the zeros of the quadratic polynomial. It highest degree is 2 means 100%, at most not more than 2, 2 are less zeros. Okay, 1 comma 3 are the zeros of the polynomial. Now relation between the roots and the roots, nothing but the zeros, zeros and the coefficients, these are the zeros. What are the coefficients in this one? Coefficients is equal to, observe that. Now 2x square minus 8x plus 6. This is comparison ax square plus bx plus c. Okay, for suppose. Now comparing with ax square plus bx plus c. These are the coefficients, a, b, c are the coefficients. A value is equal to, b value is equal to minus 8, c value is equal to 6. A value 2, b value minus 8, c value 6. Now what happened? For suppose, these are the zeros, these are the coefficients. How to write the relation? How to write the relation? Simply observe that. For suppose, sum of the roots. What are the roots? Sum of the roots, nothing but the sum of the zeros. Now 1 plus 3, that equal to 4. That equal to 4. Now this is the roots. Now this roots relation we will express in the coefficients. That equal to 100%, observe that. Minus of minus 8 by 2. Ax square plus bx plus c. Minus of b value is minus 8. Minus of minus 8 means plus 8 by 2. 8 by 2 means how much? 4. That is the formula. That equal to minus of minus 8 means, what is the minus 8? Coefficient of x by 2. What is the 2? Coefficient of x square. That equal to minus b by a. We remember that one. Sum of the roots, sum of the zeros is equal to, sum of the zeros is equal to, sum of the zeros is equal to 1 plus 3 means, what, per suppose the roots are alpha, beta, per suppose alpha plus beta is equal to, that is minus b by a. What the formula means? Minus b by a. That equal to minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. It's enough. Now product of the roots. Product of the roots means how many roots are there? Product of roots, nothing but the zeros. No problem at all. 1 into 3. That equal to 3. 3 is the answer. But this is the roots. This will be converted into the coefficients. Now observe that 6 by 2. 6 by 2 means 100%? 3. What is 6? Constant. Constant by coefficient of x square. Constant by coefficient of x square. Constant by coefficient of x square. That equal to c by a. That equal to c by a. Now sum of the roots is equal to formula minus b by a. Product of the roots is equal to formula c by a. Alpha plus beta is equal. If the examination point of view, per suppose, product of the roots is given, sum of the roots is given, find the quadratic equation. Understand or not? How to find? Just in general, you observe that. Understand or not? Sum of the roots, ax square plus bx plus c is the quadratic polynomial. Sum of the roots formula minus b by a, that is minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. Product of the roots is equal to constant by coefficient of x square c by a. Understood? Okay, now listen carefully. For suppose, ax square plus bx plus c. Now same this one, 2x square minus, general, in general, for suppose, ax square plus bx plus c. This is the quadratic polynomial. It have how many roots? 2 roots. Alpha comma beta are the roots. What are the factors? X minus alpha into x minus beta. X minus alpha comma x minus beta are the factors of the polynomial. Now product is equal to that one. Now how to write? Ax square plus bx plus c is equal to, what is the leading coefficient? leading coefficient is something, not A, something K, you write down K. K is equal to, suppose, x minus alpha into x minus beta, whatever may be K. Suppose K. Now that is A or not, after we will discuss. Now what happened? K into, multiply each and every one, x square minus beta x minus alpha x plus alpha into beta. Now K into x square minus x taken common, alpha plus beta into x plus alpha into beta. Now both are comparing the similar coefficients. K x square coefficient K, x square coefficient K is equal to A. Now x coefficient minus K into alpha plus beta. Okay, x coefficient, here x coefficient is B. B is equal to minus K into alpha plus beta. Understand or not? Now constant C is equal to K into alpha beta. C is equal to K into alpha beta. Now K nothing but the A already there. Now sum of the roots here. Alpha plus beta is equal to minus B by K. Both are multiplying minus, minus B by K. That equal to minus B by K means A. This is sum of the roots. Sum of the roots. Now product of the roots here, alpha beta is equal C by K. K value is already A, that equal C by A, no doubt at all, by comparison. Now sum of the roots is equal to formula C minus B by A, product of the roots is equal C by A. Understand or not? Yes. Now we have discussed about the, find the zeros of the quadratic polynomial. Zeros of the quadratic polynomial, verify the relations between the zeros and coefficients. What are the zeros of the polynomial? First you can find and verify roots and the zeros and the coefficients. Now first of all, the question is x square plus 7x plus 10. Find the zeros of the quadratic polynomial and verify the relation between the zeros and the coefficients. X square plus 7x plus 10. By factorization method, we can find the factors. What are the roots? Now, here coefficient is 1. 1 into 10, 10. What are the factors of 10 means? 1 into 10, 10. 10 into 1, 1. 5 into 2. Okay? Now, 5 into 2. 5 plus 2 is 7. Okay? Now, x square plus 5x plus 2x plus 10. Now x taken common, x plus 5, plus 2 taken common, x plus 5. Overall you can take in common x plus 5 into x plus 2. Now x is equal to minus 5, comma x is equal, whenever, for suppose x plus 5 equal to 0, this is 0, x plus 2 equal to 0, this is the factor, no doubt at all. Now x is equal to minus 5, 0 of the polynomial, and x is equal to minus 2 is the 0 of the polynomial. Now verify sum of the roots, product of the roots. Sum of the roots formula you know very well. Here once you observe that A value 1, B value 7, C value 10. Now sum of the roots. Sum of the roots, you know the formula, sum of the roots. Minus 5 minus 2, that equal to minus 7. Now what is the formula? Minus B by A. Minus B by A. That equal to minus of minus B by A, minus 7 by A1. Minus B by A. Sum of the roots is equal to formula minus B by A. Minus B by A. Minus 7 by 1. That is called minus B by A. Product of the roots formula. This is going to be minus B by A. Product of the roots. Product of the roots formula, product of the roots means what are the roots? Minus 5 into minus 2. That equal 10. That equal 10 means C by 10 by 1 you write. 10 means C by A. C by A. Very simple problems. First we find the factors. After that sum of the roots, product of the roots. This is the process for the quadratic polynomial. Now we will find the next one is the same process for cubic polynomial. First of all, we will take the cubic polynomial. What happened? Cubic polynomial. How many roots have the cubic polynomial? at most 3. 3 or less than 3, not more than 3, 100%. Every cubic polynomial having at most 3 roots, not more than 3 roots. But suppose we will take the cubic polynomial 2x cube. Let us consider cubic polynomial 2x cube minus 5x square minus 14x plus 8. This is the cubic polynomial. Do you think once, how many zeros of this polynomial? Means 3 zeros, at most 3. Okay, we will consider the 3 zeros. What 0 means? What is the meaning of the 0? What is the meaning of 0 means? That polynomial value must be equal to 0. Okay, but suppose 4 comma minus 2 comma 1 by 2. Observe that. 4 comma minus 2 comma 1 by 2. How to find the zeros? Okay, I will explain later. But observe that. 4 comma minus 2 comma 1 by 2 are the zeros of the above polynomial. 0 means must and should. This 4 must be satisfies this polynomial, means is equal to 0. Minus 2 must be satisfies this polynomial. 1 by 2 must be satisfied this polynomial. Satisfied means the value 4, you can replace x by 4. We can substitute in this one. This value is equal to 0. For suppose minus 2, you can substitute in this place of x. That value is equal to 0. Replace x by 1 by 2. That value is equal to 0. For suppose the value equal to 0 means 0. Otherwise, it is not a root or 0 of the polynomial. Now, observe that sum of the roots. First, we are thinking about the sum of the roots. Now, here ax square plus bx plus cx plus d. Ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. Ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. Now, sum of the roots. What happened? Now, observe that. Sum of the roots means 4 minus 2 plus 1 by 2. Calculation part is going on. 4 minus 2 means 2. 2 plus 1 by 2, that equal 2 plus 1, 2 2's are 4 plus 1, that is 5 by 2, that equal to 5 by 2. Here, observe that A value is 2, B value is minus 5, C value is minus 14, D value is 8. A 2, B minus 5, C comparison of AX cube plus BX square plus CX plus D. A value 2, B value minus 5, C value minus 14, D value 8. 5 by 2 is there. 5 by 2. Where is the 5 is known? Minus 5 is there. But here 5 by 2 means you write as minus minus 5 by 2. Again, minus into minus plus. You know? Yeah. These are the actually roots. Okay, this is converted into the coefficients. Coefficients means A, B, C, D are the coefficient. That is equal to minus of minus 5. Minus 5 nothing but the B. B by A. This is the formula. Sum of the roots formula minus B by A. Understand? Next, product of the roots. Observe that. Product of the roots means 4 into minus 2 into 1 by 2. Product. 3 roots means you can product. 4 roots, but suppose the equation have, the polynomial have the 4 roots, we will product the 4 roots. Okay. Now, product of the roots. That equal to 2, 2 cancel. 4 into minus 1 is there. That is minus 4. In this one, where is the minus 4? Product of the roots. Product of the roots means minus 4 means, observe that. For suppose you write this one, minus 8 by 2, no doubt at all. Minus 8 by 2 nothing but the minus 4. Minus 8 by 2. 8 means how much? D. Minus D by A. Product of the roots. Product of the roots is minus D by A. That is the formula. AX cube plus BX square plus CX plus D. This is the cubic polynomial, keep in mind. AX cube plus BX square plus CX plus D. Sum of the roots formula. What is the formula? Minus B by A. Product of the roots formula. What is the formula? Minus D by A. Understood? Now, another one relation is there. Means quadratic means only two conditions, sum of the roots, product of the, but it is a cubic equation. Means we will take the another relation. What are the relation means? Sum of the product of the zeros taken to at a time. For suppose observe that alpha, beta, gamma are the roots taken to at a time. And sum and product. For suppose alpha, beta will take product, alpha into beta, next beta into gamma, next alpha into gamma. Now sum of the product. Product and sum. This is the another relation. Now same we'll take 4 into minus 2. What is that? Product of the roots taken to at a time. This is another relation. Product of two roots taken to at a time. The sum of product of the two roots taken, sum of the product of the roots, sum of the product of roots taken to at a time. Now what happened? Product 4 into minus 2 plus minus 2 into 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 into 4 means 4 into 1 by 2. Understood? 4 into minus 2 means minus 8. 2, 2 cancel. This is minus 1. 2 1s are 2, 2s are. This is plus 2. Minus 8 minus 1 means minus 9 plus 2. That equal minus 7. How to write the minus 7? That is equal to, here value is minus 7. Understand or not? The value is minus 7 is there. Now you write as this one, minus 14 by 2. Any doubt? Minus 7 equal to minus 14 by 2. Minus 14 means, what is the minus 14? C by A. Verify, first of all, what is the exam? These are the roots. Verify the quadratic polynomial have the three roots. Three roots is given. Means we can substitute those values in the equation. We'll get the 0, 0, 0. After that, verification. How to verify means sum of the roots means formula this one. Product of the roots, how to verify this one? Sum of the product of the two roots. Sum of the product of the roots taken to at a time. Taken to at a time. Equal C by A. Now, you have identified one formula. What is the formula? You observe that. Now cubic equation is there. Generalization. Now we will go to the generalization. For suppose, what is the generalization? Observe that. For suppose the general formula is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. This is, now you know that. First, how many roots are there? Maximum roots 3. Alpha, beta, gamma are the roots. Alpha, beta, gamma are the roots. Okay, 3 roots. Now sum of the roots. First one, alpha plus beta plus gamma. Sum of the roots. What is the formula? Sum of the roots minus b by a is the formula. Here clearly. Next, sum of the product of the roots taken to at a time. Taken to at a time means alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha. What is the formula? Alpha beta beta gamma gamma alpha formula is C by A only. Here clearly observe that. C by A. Next, third one, product of the roots alpha beta gamma. Alpha beta gamma already, product of the roots is equal to formula minus D by A. Minus D by A. Minus D by A. Simple. You remember sum of the roots formula minus B by A. Sum of the product of the two roots taken at a time, that equals C by A. Product of the three roots is equal to minus D by A. Understood? Okay. Now, you write the relation. You will take one problem. Find out the relation between the roots and the zeros and the coefficients. Now, one more problem we will do. For suppose, 2x cube plus 14x square minus 5x minus 9. This is the cubic polynomial. Write the relation between the roots and the coefficients. How many roots are there? 3 roots. For suppose alpha, beta, gamma. Sum of the roots. Let alpha, beta, gamma are the roots. Now first we write A value is equal to B value equal to 14. C value is equal to minus 5. D value is equal to minus 9. Understood? Now sum of the first one, alpha plus beta plus gamma. What is the formula? Minus b by a. Minus b value. B value is 14 by a. A value is 2. That is called minus 7. Next, number 2. The sum of the product of the two roots taken 2 at a time. Alpha beta plus beta gamma plus gamma alpha. That equal, what is the formula? C by A. Just C by A. That equal C means minus 5 by 2. Third one, product of the roots. Alpha beta gamma. What is the formula? Minus D by A. Minus D value. D value is minus 9 by 2. That equal 9 by 2. Okay. This is the how to find the roots alpha plus beta plus